Let it stick with space and turn now to companies that are finding ways to explore beyond Earth's atmosphere. Space Prospective hopes to expand its presence as a climate-friendly space tourism company. It's testing out its Neptune capsule to take customers on a six-hour round-trip journey to the edge of space as soon as 2025. Tickets are already sold out for the next few years. I'm pleased to say here with us in studio with more is Jane Poynter. She is CEO and co-founder of Space Prospective. Jane, so good to see you.
Hello there. Hi.
So tell us a little bit about the spacecraft that you've got planned. It's not going to be taken it's not taking people up using the Falcon Heavy, is it? But is it going to be a rocket ship ride or something more like a hot air balloon?
So we don't use rockets. We use a space balloon, which is actually the size of a small football stadium at full size when it's up in space. And it's carrying a capsule for eight customers and a captain very gently. It goes to space at 12 miles an hour.
Oh.
What's really useful about that for our customers is that it makes it incredibly accessible because the journey is really gentle. And it takes, on these initial suborbital flights, it takes us 2 hours to get up there, 2 hours at the top, and 2 hours down. And if you can get on an airplane, you can get on spaceship Neptune. So as a business, this means it really throws open the doors
on the
market.
So you don't have to do as much preparation as
you don't
passenger.
Do any of the preparation. Yeah. You don't have high Gs. You don't need a suit. Mm-hmm. None of that. You don't actually have microgravity, which for some people is a little disorienting. So we don't have any of that. Instead, we have this super comfortable capsule with a space lounge inside that has a bar and a loo and Wi-Fi, you know, all the comforts that you would want to have when you're going up to have
Wi-Fi.
This. Of course.
Who are people texting while they're up there? Shouldn't they just be
They're sending pictures to everyone.
That's funny because actually we've been talking about maybe we should actually accidentally turn the Wi-Fi off for a little bit in the middle so people are forced to look at the Earth with their eyes.
Yeah.
Because every astronaut that has ever been to space, anyone who's ever been to space, comes back and talks about this experience as something profound. Like it truly is profound for them. And so that's why we're taking people to space.
Have you had test runs yet?
Yeah, so we've done flights. Actually, we've flown a capsule heavier than our capsule to space. We actually have flown a human higher than we're flying this. So we broke the Red Bull Stratos jump earlier a few years ago, if you remember that. And so then we're about to get into uncrewed flights with the actual capsule that we'll be taking people in later this year, we're anticipating. And not going to give you a date on that, but watch this space. You'll be hearing about it sometime soon.
Well, I mean, when we talk about the product, you sold a lot of tickets for this. There's obviously a lot of interest in it. But, I mean, what is kind of the total market? I mean, this is still obviously a trip for wealthy people right now. Do we get to a point, do you see in the near future, where the prices come down and maybe it's a little bit more accessible to just the average Joe, maybe?
Yeah, so it's super interesting, right? So right now we are at that early adopter phase of the market, right? So our customers, we're seeing we sold over 1,750 tickets already. And our customers are, at the moment, people that have dreamt all their lives of going to space, never thought it was something they were going to be able to do in their lifetime, or they want to be the first to do something. You know, we price it to be right in that luxury travel market, to go to market.
Yeah.
What's the ticket price?
$125,000, right?
Which isn't that bad. It's funny, we were talking on this program. Well, we were talking on this program a couple weeks ago about the Four Seasons is launching a new cruise ship, and we were talking about the prices on those were in the high five figures, and that was just to stay on Earth.
Right. Now, think in historically about aviation.
Yeah.
So the first commercial flights were over 100 years ago, handful of people going on them, mostly wealthy people, and now we can't live without it. And so we are at that stage in this industry where you're just at that inflection point where you're going to start seeing a lot of people going. And of course, with that, ticket prices do come down.
Well, what about safety? Because you mentioned the early days of flight.
Yeah.
We were missing that point out, the early days of flight. There were a lot of accidents involved. It was a process here.
Yeah, well, at that point, though, remember, there wasn't really the experience that there is today, and there wasn't the regulatory environment that there is today.
Okay.
So we're regulated.
Yeah.
We're regulated by the FAA. We have enormous amounts of experience. So this balloon, what's super interesting is that most people probably haven't ever heard of a space balloon or this kind of balloon that we're using, right? It's actually been flown thousands of times by NASA, by the European Space Agency, our team. Members of our team have flown it many times, mostly for research. And so it's a very well understood technology. There hasn't been an incident in the last 20 years. So even the technology itself is super safe. And then, of course, with the whole procedures and the policies and the way we do work in human spaceflight, which I've been in my entire career, there's a whole way of doing redundancy to make it incredibly safe. Like there's parachutes, right? Even though this balloon itself is incredibly safe, you have to have a backup. And for us, the backup is parachutes, and there's four of them. And only one of them needs to work.
Do you have to wear a spacesuit?
No, that's the beauty of it. We could be sitting here like this. We could actually do this from up there. We could do a show from up there.
That's why you need the Wi-Fi for
I'm sure we'll get that approved. the cost might be a little prohibited. Did I read you correctly? Were you in the biosphere too?
I was. I was on the design team, and I lived inside biosphere 2 for 2 years and 20 minutes. And that is actually...
2 years and 20 minutes. Love
it. That is actually what got me on this journey to take us all to space. Because that's what I want to do. I want to take as many people as possible to space.
All right. Really appreciate your joining us today. Jane Poynter, CEO and co-founder of Space Prospective with, of course, their high-tech space balloon. $125,000 for a ticket to go to space. It's about 6 hours total round trip.